Hello everyone, my name is Kumar Aditya and in this video I will show you the simulation for asymmetrical clamp mode control. So if you see my plot window, the last plot is the output voltage of this full bridge inverter. And you can notice the positive half cycle of this output voltage waveform is narrow compared to the negative half cycle. So it has an unsymmetrical wave shape, and because of this unsymmetrical wave shape, its control is known as asymmetrical clamp mode control or asymmetrical voltage cancellation control. So how to control your inverter to generate this kind of wave shape? So here on the top, I am showing the gating signal for switches M1 and M2 of my inverter, that is switches in leg A of my inverter. And in the second plot, I am showing the gating signal for M3 and M4, that is switches in the leg B of the inverter. To generate this kind of wave shape, you need to switch either leg A or leg B at fixed 50% duty cycle. So in this simulation, I'm switching my leg B at 50% duty cycle. So you can notice the second plot, the gating signal for M3 and M4 have equal width. So I have inserted a dead time here to avoid shoot through port. And the gating signal for leg A, I varied by varying my duty cycle. So you can see the pulse width of the gating signal for M1 and M2 have unequal width. And with this ratio of width will change with changing the duty cycle of your control strategy. So currently this is for duty cycle of 0.15. Let me show you what happens if I increase the duty cycle to 0.4. Please also notice the change in this output voltage. So if I increase my duty cycle, you notice the width ratio of the switches in leg A has now changed. However, the switching ratio or width of the gating signal of the switches in leg B is still at 50%. And the output voltage here, you can notice the width of the positive half cycle has increased. So your average output voltage of the inverter will increase, so you can deliver more power to your load. So let me just show you the current shape here. So here you see the current is sinusoidal. I have used RLC load to show you that the current is sinusoidal, because you know this type of controller strategy is mainly used in load resonant converter. So you can imagine if you use this type of control in a simple RL load inverter, you, because of this unsymmetrical wave shape, output voltage is highly distorted and your distortion will reflect into your load current. So generally this is not used in the conventional inverter, but mainly preferred in the resonant type of converter, where you know this RLC acts as a band pass filter and filters out most of the harmonics in your load current, and you get a fairly sinusoidal load current. So how to implement this? So it's fairly simple. I'm using one voltage source to act as my carrier wave. So here, this gray plot is a ramp signal of 100 kilohertz. Another voltage source I'm using to model my duty cycle. So currently set to 0.4. And these two signals are being fed to these two comparator here. So you can pause the video and see how I have connected or how I am feeding this VC and D to this comparator. So all you need is just two comparator. So each comparator will generate one gating signal, and from one each gating signal, I'm generating two complementary gating signal for each leg of my inverter. So this gate driver here is a custom gate driver which I myself simulated, and you can watch it how I did it in the link mentioned in the description of this video. But you don't need the custom gate driver. You can use any hub bridge gate driver available in the LTspice library, or you can just use a controlled voltage source to act as your gate driver, as I did in my phase shift control video. So again, I will post the link in the description so you can watch it there. So that's it. One thing I would like to point out here is that if I vary my duty cycle, I'm only controlling the positive half cycle of this output voltage. So even if I decrease my duty cycle to zero, I will still have half of the voltage available across my output of this inverter. You see, I made my duty cycle zero, but I still have the negative half cycle of the output voltage. However, positive half cycle has become zero. So this type of control cannot be used in the application where you need to vary the output power from, you know, zero to the full range, as it can only reduce the output power to minimum half of the nominal value. So can you imagine application where you need to control your output power in such a manner? If you have the answer, please leave that in the comment section. Till then, bye bye.